Hi, welcome to PiSignage. In today's video, we're going to cover how to schedule playlists within your group. Using this feature, you can have your players automatically switch between playlists either based on the time of day or the day of the week. Using this feature, you can set up all your players to play your content without needing your intervention. For today's video, I've signed into my account in PiSignage.com. I also have two playlists, Cars and Cows, which have pictures of cars and cows respectively. We also have our player, which is Demo TV, which is the screen that you see right over here playing. You also see it's part of the default group. And if you go to our group, click on the default group. This is the screen where we will schedule all of our playlists. You can see a default playlist up top over here. A default playlist basically is a playlist that plays when nothing else is scheduled to play in that group. While you could have a playlist like we have over here called Cars playing, you also have the option to put TV off playlist like some of our customers do. Putting the TV off playlist as the default playlist ensures that your TV is off when you have nothing scheduled to play. With that being said, let's just schedule our first playlist. I'm just going to schedule two playlists, the first one being Cars and the second one being Cars. I'm going to change our default playlist to be the TV off playlist. And now, whenever Cars or Cows is not scheduled to play, the TV will be turned off. You can also see here that we have a priority. Since Cars is on top of the Cows playlist, it is going to get priority, which means that since both of them are scheduled to play at the same time, Cars is going to play, whereas Cows is going to be hidden. To schedule our two playlists at a specific given time, you can click on the calendar icon, which gives you an option to schedule it according to a duration, which means that you could schedule it to play between two specific dates. You could choose to play it only on selected days. We could say it plays on all days, or we could say that it only plays on Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. For now, we're going to just check all and say all days. You could choose again for it to play on specific dates, which allows you to select very specific days of the month. You can choose a specific time. We could say that it plays from 12 a.m. until 12 p.m. Or 11 a.m. until 12 p.m., etc. You could also schedule it in 3, 4, or 5 week cycles. This means that it would play on specific dates or days or times, but in cycles, which means it'll either play on the first week of every month, second week of every month, third week, so on. So now that we've seen all of the scheduling options, I'm just going to click on save, which has all of our scheduling options saved. And we could do the same thing for our second playlist. You can schedule playlists, you could schedule as many playlists as you want. So you could, in theory, have 5, 6, 7, 8, as many playlists as you want. But for now, we're just going to have the two playlists, Cars and Cows, so that we could demonstrate some of the other options that you have right here. So now that I've deleted the other playlist, we have Cars and Cows. Cars sits on top, so it is at a higher priority. So for now, if I were to click on deploy, we can see over here that the Cars playlist plays and it cycles through all of our car images, which are three images playing at 3 second intervals each. And it's just going to keep playing Cars and ignore Cows altogether. We can now look at the deploy options, which will give us a few options when we have multiple playlists scheduled to play at the same time. For the first option, which is play default playlist along with scheduled playlist, it's first going to play the default playlist, and at the end of the default playlist, it's going to switch to whatever playlist is scheduled at the same time. So for that, I'm just going to click on this, and I'm going to change the default playlist to be Cows, and I'm going to remove the second playlist that we had scheduled. So now, with the option selected, it's first going to play the Cows playlist, followed by the Cars playlist. As you can see here, we have deployed the same. So we have the pictures of the cows, which are three pictures, 3 seconds each of cows. And from here, it's going to switch to the Cars playlist that we had scheduled at the same time. I'm going to go on to the second option, which is to combine content of all scheduled playlists. This means that if we were to just switch the default playlist back to TV off and schedule the cars playlist for the same time as the cars playlist, I'm going to check this option. And what it is going to do is going to play all of the content from the cars playlist followed by the content in the cars playlist. Very similar to what we just saw. We also see an option here that says alternate content from selected playlists. What this is going to allow us to do is it's going to combine all of the content so that you have one image from the cars playlist, one image from the cars playlist, one image from the cars playlist, and so on. To see that in action, I'm just going to click on deploy. And now we have the content from both playlists alternating. So we had a cow, now it's going to be a car again, and a cow, so on, so forth. The next option we have is shuffle content every cycle. What this is going to do is it's going to change the order of all of the assets in every cycle that it plays through. So for this, I'm just going to deploy. And we should now see that it's a random picture of a cow, followed by a car, followed by a different cow. And this order is not going to repeat in the next cycle where it will choose a completely different or random order. This is a great option when you want to cycle through your content randomly and you don't want to make it too predictable for your audience. We are now ready to go through our final option, which is switch to new at the end of a current playlist. This essentially means that if you had one playlist running and it's not cycled through all of its content yet, but according to the schedule, the next playlist is due to play. This option makes sure that the first playlist completes and cycles through all of its content before the switch happens, regardless of what is scheduled when. Now, while you can schedule all of your playlists over here, you also have the option to view schedule. For this demo, I've scheduled them for the weekdays of Sunday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday for cars, and Wednesday, Monday, and Tuesday for the playlist cows. So now when we click on view schedule, we can see what is due to play when, and this can be seen for the entire calendar year, where you can see what playlist is going to play when. This is a great way to get an overview of what your schedule looks like before you deploy. You also have the option to deploy now, or assuming that you finish setting up your schedule, but you still have content playing through the day, you also have the option over here to deploy at a later given time. In our example, since we want to deploy at midnight, I'm just going to choose 11:59 p.m. The deploy is most likely to happen at 11:59 p.m. tonight rather than right now, which means fewer people are going to see the transition as the player switches from the old content to the new content. As always, if you have any questions, thoughts, or concerns, you can always write to support@pisignage.com. With that, we come to the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.